Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. And welcome to a new series I'm going to be doing where I'm testing some of the most viral skincare products, skincare hacks, techniques, and advice that we see mainly on TikTok. And today I'm going to be testing one of the most viral products over on the Tikular Talk. That is the Vue de Palang Frozen Cream. I had to try it for myself. I was very, very intrigued. There are countless videos hyping up this freezer-friendly cream, and this is a K-beauty brand I've never heard of, and I'm like a K-beauty geek. Like, I love, I live for Korean skincare. So I got this product online. It was so long ago. I ordered this like a month ago, and it only just showed up, but I did find you can get this on the Beauty Spy for around $17. So what is this product? Why is it viral? What does it claim to do? The first thing I have to say is this product seems to be viral for how the product looks and the gimmick behind the product rather than what it claims to actually do and what it can do for your skin. So according to the Beauty Spy, the Vue de Palang Frozen Cream is a freezable gel face cream that is cooling on the skin whilst helping diminish the appearance of wrinkles. It adds moisture to the skin and helps brighten the skin's appearance for a more overall radiant look. Whilst the brand themselves actually claims that this product freezes your troubles away by cooling irritation, soothing sensitive skin, tightening the pores, and using ingredients that brings down the skin's temperature. So yeah, it's basically a moisturizer you can keep in your freezer, in your fridge, or at room temperature. Now, if you are familiar with Korean skincare K-beauty, you would know that this isn't really the first of its kind. The now discontinued Real Squeeze Aloe Vera Ice Pack from Nature Republic was pretty much the same thing. It's a cream that you keep in your freezer, and its benefits is that it feels cold. And in my personal experience using this product a few years back, whilst this was nice and cooling in summer, it was a pain to use because I kept forgetting I had it because it was with the frozen meat in the freezer, and that's not where I keep my skincare. So with that said, my prediction before I use this product was that I wasn't really going to get much use out of it other than a one-time fun gimmicky kind of like, oh, look what it does, it's frozen. So before I give you my thoughts and opinions and show you how the product works, let's take a deeper dive into the ingredients and product claims. So they talk about pore tightening, and I feel like this product is relying on the idea that people still think cold makes your pores tighter. We all know your pores can't open and close with hot and cold water or hot temperatures and cold temperatures. Your pores do kind of do this like goose bumpy thing where they can temporarily look smaller, and that's all this product can do. However, it does contain niacinamide, which helps even out skin tone, it keeps your skin barrier nice and healthy, can help regulate sebum production, and has been known to potentially help with the appearance of enlarged pores. But when you look at the ingredients, this is really, other than the coldness, the only pore tightening or pore clearing or pore resizing potential ingredient that is in this product. We have glycerin and sodium hyaluronate for hydration. We have allantoin, which helps soothe the skin, calms inflammation as well, alongside adenosine. Adenosine, I never know how to pronounce that. Then we have some citrus fruit extracts, which I'm not mad at. You don't often find the same irritants in citrus fruit extracts as you do essential oils. And what do we have in here? Is the citrus lemon fruit extract that we have in here is probably just in there for a super, super gentle exfoliation. In typical K-beauty fashion, this contains birch sap. It's a very promising hydrating ingredient, actually, and alongside the bamboo water, which you find in here, a lot of Korean skincare actually use these instead of regular water, just for that added dose of hydration. You have a lot of extracts as well, which have little to no research behind, water lily, which I'm like, okay. We do also have mentha rotundifolia leaf extract, which is apple mint. So it's still part of the menthol family. However, it's got very low menthol content. Usually when you use cooling products, you're going to find a mint of sorts in there, some kind of menthol ingredient, which I personally don't like putting on the skin. However, I'll tell you now that this product doesn't have that hard-hitting minty shower gel, you know, like wake you up feeling. I did actually mention that niacinamide and the coldness was actually one of the only potentially pore tightening ingredients. However, apple mint is also known to be a tonic, so it can actually help reduce the appearance of enlarged pores as well. Is it the most effective? Probably not. With the use of niacinamide over time, it could definitely help. So whilst the apple mint extract isn't going to give you that really strong minty menthol feeling that a lot of pore tightening creams have to make you kind of think the product's working, what we do have is a synthetic derivative of menthol. Methoxypropidinol is a synthetic derivative of menthol that's probably going to give you that kind of the minty fragrance, the feeling, the zinginess. But you can definitely feel a cooling sensation from this, even when stored at room temperature. So I think that's probably why that's in there, to give you that zingy, cooling feeling, even when it's not been stored in the freezer. We also have mushroom in here, which I'm already bored of. It's everywhere now, it's everywhere, but it's a good antioxidant and has some anti-inflammatory properties as well. So whilst this is an interesting hydrating cream, there's no occlusives in here. So this product really is for those people with super oily skin. I would totally avoid this if you had dry skin or dehydrated skin. And of course, this product will be formulated to go in and out of different temperatures. So freezer, fridge, room temperature. So I wouldn't now start go freezing all your skincare, you know? We know that. So really, minus a few kind of questionable ingredients, this really is just a soothing, calming, potentially pore refining cream, not moisturizer like a gel cream. But as we know, you can't just review skincare by reading the ingredient list. So let's actually try it. So as I mentioned, you can keep this in the fridge or at room temperature or freeze for 30 minutes as the brand recommends. 30 minutes to an hour and then apply like you would do a moisturizer after your serums. Texture wise, it's a little bit thicker than your normal gel cream. It doesn't have much of a fragrance at all either, despite those few extracts that are in there. At room temperature, this is slightly cooling on the skin, again, probably because of that tiny bit of menthol in there. But it lasts seconds, like once it's on, it's gone. It gives you an initial kind of like, oh, that's chilly, and then it's kind of gone. But for me, this just isn't hydrating enough. As someone with a very, very oily T-zone and a dry U-zone, this just wasn't, like, it felt like it disappeared too quick once it went onto my skin. When I use hydrating moisturizers or hydrating creams, serums, toners, whatever, I like to see that on my skin. I like to see the glow from those hydrating ingredients. This almost, in a way, mattified my skin, and I didn't really feel anything from it. Frozen, of course, it's really fucking cold. And it does feel super soothing and calming. Of course, it's frozen. Any cooling, cold sensation on irritated or inflamed skin is gonna help cool that down, soothe it, get rid of some irritation and redness as well. But again, other than that, that cold soothing feeling actually disappeared pretty quick, even when frozen. And of course, again, not supplying enough hydration for me. Of course, we're gonna see no pore tightening benefits within the first use because that doesn't happen, that just doesn't happen. Even with cold water or cold cream, we're not gonna see a huge difference. With niacinamide over time, we may start to see that difference. To conclude, I feel like it's just a very basic hydrating cream with a clever gimmick to it, to be honest. It's kind of useless. Like, I don't see this fitting in anywhere in my routine. And whilst the cold does feel nice and provide some relief from irritation, we kind of know that's all the cold is good for here. It may help de-puff, maybe, but the idea of closing pores, we know that's not how temperature works on the skin. Will this be nice in summer to cool down your skin if you're sunburnt? Absolutely, or you just wanna cool down for a bit. It'll be really nice for a couple seconds. But to be honest, my alternative, a reusable alternative, is one of those tools that you just put in your face and it's got that bit of metal on the bottom and it cools down your skin and it always stays cold. You don't even have to keep it in the fridge. You can keep it on your vanity where you're gonna see it and actually use it. There is just not enough impressive ingredients separate from the gimmick of being able to freeze this for me to be like, wow, I need this frozen cream forever. Like, make room in the freezer, push the peas aside, you know, I need to make room for my moisturizer. It's never gonna happen. And the whole usage of it, the whole user experience, it's such a pain to have to like do your skincare and then run down to the freezer, use it, then let it thaw out and then make sure it's frozen again in time for you to use it the next day. The just logistics of it and remembering to freeze it, remembering to defrost it, or if you've oven frozen it, it just doesn't sit into my relaxing skincare routine. And whilst this is cute, it's fun, it's a great gimmick. I like the odd gimmick in my skincare. I like a gimmick alongside a good effective product. And Vue de Pelang's frozen cream is somewhat average. Like, it's a very average product that they're like, freeze it, why not, give it a go, you know? Will I be using this again? Probably not. Will I be recommending it? No. No, I don't think so. And that's the thing with viral products online, is they don't necessarily have to be a good product. They just have to do something visually amazing, like being frozen or giving you an instant glow. And this is a very, very good example of good marketing, a good gimmick, and people always looking for that next interesting viral product as well. Let me know what you think. Have you tried this before? Do you think it's just a load of crap? Let me know. We'll be trialing another TikTok trend in a couple of weeks. It's a weird one, the next one. I'm not sure I'm gonna have skin left by the end of it. You can actually check out a few TikTok and other reaction videos here, and some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.